Hi there, I'm Matt, and today I'm in a steam locomotive workshop, and I want to show how to scan large parts with the ZEISS T-SCAN Hawk 2. When scanning large parts, it is very important that your system fulfills the measurement requirements, like details and accuracy of the feature that needs to be scanned. If you, for example, need to scan a feature with an accuracy of 0.1 mm, you need to make sure that the accuracy of your system is higher than the accuracy of the element, as you do not want to doubt the result. The T-SCAN Hawk 2 is the first portable laser scanner with the new satellite mode. To scan these large objects up to multiple meters, no need for the classical built-in photogrammetry with coded markers. No compromise on accuracy or doubt on the results. Here we have a train frame. Before we start scanning, we are placing our dice with reference points on the part. They are simply distributed on or next to the object, which enables a quick setup. If you want to inspect some features directly on the object, you can also use magnetic or adhesive reference points, which can be used for inspection. We are going to have a look at this method later on. For the scan of such large components, we use T-SCAN Hawk 2 and its new satellite mode to create a stable backbone of reference points, which is used for scanning or part inspection. We can start this by using the button workflow. The reference points are captured from different angles. The projected grid will help to position the sensor quickly and intuitively on the measurement setup. After capturing the reference points, the object can be scanned. This can be a scan of the complete part or certain areas of interest. A small note at this point, the areas of interest do not need to be connected, as this is done by the stable backbone of the reference points. Remember that we mentioned that you can put some reference points on single features to inspect them. The advantage of the T-SCAN Hawk 2 and the satellite mode is that you can also inspect reference points directly using the 3D scanner like a mobile tactile measuring machine. For example, two planes to check distance, parallelism or perpendicularity. Next to this, you can also use so-called adapters. These are elements that you can create on your own and are automatically recognized by the software to determine the distance of two holes, for example. The whole scan and inspection is complete in under 15 minutes. I'm now using the time I have gained to clean up and look at the steam train collection here at the location. For more how-tos, getting started tutorials, product updates or any other questions on 3D scanning, please go to handsonmetrology.com. You will find the link in the information section of the video. Thanks for watching and see you next time.